Hello guys, welcome to my 6th class of Laplace Transform. Suppose if you like my videos, please like, put a like button and also you subscribe my channel. Thank you. See, now we are going to continue for Laplace Transform for some more functions. We discussed already in 5th class how to solve Laplace Transform for trigonometric function, exponential function, hyperbolic function. Now I am going to take different from what we discussed in the previous class. I want to find out Laplace transform of this function. Therefore, what we are going to do, first we have to take Laplace transform of the given function. This is a given function, root of e power of 4 into t plus 3 plus of second function. What's the second function? E power of minus 2t into sine 3t. Okay? Now here we have more than one term, therefore I go for linear probability. First you take Laplace transform of first term plus Laplace transform of the second term. Therefore this can be written as Laplace transform of root of e power of 4 into t plus 3 plus Laplace transform of second function e power of minus 2t into sin 3t. This is by using linear property. Now after that, for our convenience, both the terms they have a more than one function, and for time being I am going to take this as a star. First I have to find out Laplace transform first function, similarly I have to find out Laplace transform second function. I am going to substitute the star. Therefore Laplace transform of first function is root of p power of 4 into t plus 3. If you want to do it together, do it your choice. For our convenient, for our simple manner, what we are going to do, I will take it separately. Now, we can't have any formula for root function. This can also be written as e power of 4t, I take 4 inside the bracket, plus 3, 4 rise to the power of half. Because you know that cube root of x square is nothing but x square to the power of 1 by 3. That is nothing but x to the power of 2 by 3. Like that. Now, actually 4 is outside here. 4 into t plus 3. Now, this can also be written as Laplace transform of e power of, push multiplied by 4, we get 4t plus whatever that 12 divided by 2. Now we get 4t plus 12 whole divided by 2. It's nothing but this can also be written as Laplace transform of e power of. Now we get 2t plus 6. E power of a plus b can be written as e power of a 2t into e power of b 6. Now e power of 6 is a constant. This can also be written as e power of 6 into Laplace transform of e power of 2t. Now we know that one of the formula, we know that Laplace transform of e power of 2t is nothing but 1 by s minus a. Therefore from this, what we get actually, e power of 6 into 1 by s minus a is what? 2. This is nothing but Laplace transform of root of 4 into t plus 3. What I did? Now I will take that root to the power of 1. First you multiplied by 4 and take it just like x square to the power of 1 by 3, 6 square x to the power of 2 by 3. Now moving to the next second function. Laplace transform. If you want to find out this, first you write what is Laplace transform of sin 3t. Laplace transform of sin 3t is nothing but 3 by a square plus 9. This one is 9. By shifting property, Laplace transform of e power of minus 2t sin 3t is nothing but, now you know what is shifting property. Shifting property is Laplace transform of e power of at into f of t is nothing but f of capital F of s minus a, where f of s is nothing but Laplace transform of f of t. You know that this is nothing but shifting property. Now our Laplace transform is what? Sin 3t. Replace s by s minus a, but here instead of a what you have l2 minus 2, therefore now we get s plus 2, because again you have a is minus minus into minus plus 2 whole square plus 9. Therefore this implies Laplace transform of given, therefore star implies. Now Laplace transform of root of e power of 4 into t plus 3 plus e power of minus 2t into sin 3t is nothing but sum of these two. Laplace transform, this is what actually e power of 6 by s minus 2 plus t divided by s plus 2 whole square plus 9. This is nothing but Laplace transform of sum of these two. Now here I discuss how to find out Laplace transform of exponential function and also how to find out Laplace transform of product of exponential to trigonometric function by using which property? Linear property, and also by using shifting property. Now I think is everyone is clear how we get the Laplace transform. I'm moving to the second different function. I'm not going to solve more than one different type of function. If you need more than that, we please refer my website K-Murphy Maths. There available Laplace transform notes. The next function is second one. Second one is actually Laplace transform of 3 power of t plus 4t plus 5 whole cube. Yeah. Now what we are going to do, again we are going to use the linear property. Laplace transform first term plus Laplace transform of second term. This is nothing but linear property. Now in the next step, what we are going to do? Now I take beta of Laplace transform of first 3 power of t. Now I am going to take for my convenient term. We don't have any standard result what we discussed in the previous classes. The first you cover this is in the standard form. Laplace transform of e power of log of 3 power of t, because you know that e power of log of f of x is nothing but f of x. Therefore 3 power of t can be written as e power of log of 3 power of t. Now from the basic concept of logarithm, e power log of a power of m can be written as m log a. Therefore, this is nothing but e power of t into log 3. Log 3 is a constant. Now, I am going to use Laplace transform of e power of 8. What is Laplace e power of 8? Is 1 by s minus a. This implies Laplace transform of 3 power of t is nothing but t quotient is log 3. Therefore, 1 by s minus a. What is my a? Log 3. Yeah. Similarly, I want to find out Laplace transform of 4t plus 5 whole cube. First, you expand using fundamental basic formula a plus b whole cube. A plus the whole cube is nothing but a cube. A cube is nothing but 64t cube. Yes. Plus 3a square b, we get 16 into 5 into 3. Now we get 240t square, and then 3ab square. What we get? 300t plus b cube. What is b cube? Is nothing but 125, 5 whole cube. Now again by using linear property, this can be written as Laplace transform of first function is 64 into Laplace transform of t cube plus 240 into Laplace transform of t square. plus 300 into Laplace transform of t plus 125 into Laplace transform of 1. You know the formula r t square t cube by nothing but integer. We know that Laplace transform of t power of n is nothing but n factorial by s to the power of n plus 1. And also Laplace transform of 1 is nothing but 1 by s. Using this formula, we get 64 into n is equal to 3 factorial divided by 3 plus 1, 4 plus 240 into 2 factorial divided by 2 plus 1 means s cube plus 300 into 1 factorial divided by s square plus 1 by s. Not necessary to simplify this. Now take this sum that gives us Laplace transform of given function. Not necessary to write the sum. Take sum of this. I take the Roman number 1 and this is Roman number 2. Therefore, the required Laplace transform of the given function 3 power t plus 4t plus 5 whole cube is nothing but sum of Roman number 1 and 2. That gives us, but I have not written once again because it's very lengthy. Sum that gives us Laplace transform of the given function. Here I discuss how to find out Laplace transform of exponential function, a power of t, product of a power of t into f of t using shifting property, how to find out Laplace transform using t power of n. Now it is in the form of a plus b whole cube. Now I am going to consider in my further classes some more different type of functions based on some more standard result. Thank you very much for listening my time.